Good morning, ladies and gentlemen.
Good morning, ma'am.
I would like to, I am feeling honored and privileged to extend a very warm welcome to all of you. And I think in this winter morning, this by our director, Dr. Banerjee, but few minutes back, he called me up that because of some situations, he could not come. And he asked me to take this role forward. And he asked me to ask for the apologies from all of you, of the society. So I extend a very, very warm welcome to you, sir, on behalf of IIT, our students, our faculty, directors, and on my own behalf. Welcome. I would like to say a few words about eSIL first.
The reason I actually was able to get back to you, Dr. Shah, was partly because I had never addressed any institution from UP, and I belong to UP. So one of the parochial reasons for why I am here is I've never done that, and I thought this would be an opportunity because I have spoken at almost every institution across the globe, but never in my own home state. It took me some time to figure out whether Ghaziabad is in UP or is in Haryana. Because I don't belong to Western UP, but anyways. That was the reason of my speed with which I got back to you. And the reason I actually took that 2 days was simply because I was unsure whether I'm going to be around on 19th or not. I'm not sure what the audience wants to hear. And I don't believe any of us have actually reached that stage where we can be considered real change makers. So I will try to keep things simple. But before I get into my own rant for next 25 minutes, I wanted to actually understand what is it that you guys are seeking for and why are you here? Anybody want to go? Other than you, because you have been talking.
Weak information of a business plan or an idea. And just throw thoughts around, listen to people, ask people what they think about your idea.
You should be here. Anybody else? Couple of more people left.
If an artist wants to start a business, so the way the artist thinks and the way the business person has to do it, the art is different. So how he has to cope up, how he has to make the trade-off, like what should he, how he should go about. This is what I want to hear about.
You're an artist.
I think so.
Anybody else?
Sir, I am already working on an idea for last 2.5 years, and just wanted to look forward at how you are managing in the starting phase and basically the critical decisions where you are taking and how you cope up with this thing.
Check it.
So you've been saying that the ecosystem for entrepreneurship in our country is not up to the mark. I just want to know how, despite the system, somebody can actually do so much.
Okay guys, so I scribbled down some notes on the back side of the tickets, which you have so nicely funded. So I'm going to actually do two things. One, I understood that most of you would be looking for something that would allow you to make decisions. But I'm not the brightest guy to tell you how you should decide. But what I'll tell you is how I lived my life. Some of these questions will get answered. Some of these will not be getting answered. So my guess is the other colleagues will be able to help you with that. The flavor of the season is actually the Aam Aadmi Party and the extraordinary leader they've got. Arvind Kejriwal comes across the common man of R.K. Lakshman's cartoon, but if you actually look at him, he has an extraordinary journey. You don't get into IIT if you are an ordinary guy. You don't become an Indian Economic Services officer if you are an ordinary guy. And you surely don't become Chief Minister and launch a new party if you are an ordinary guy. So Arvind Kejriwal, and she landed up in 96 and discovered the palace was really a thatched British style house where things keep falling from the rooftop all the time. And being a normal person studying in Delhi University, she found it impossible to live. So by 97, I had the ultimate wife or job. And so I came to Delhi to look
at 6. And that time, the place where I reside, those areas, the newspaper is not available because of the remoteness. because there is no newspaper agency to really print that newspaper. And I studied in a school, Dunbar School High School. And then the teachers, they asked me to, every month we have to speak some the highlights of the news of the newspaper. But the place where I reside, we don't have the newspaper. So then I discussed this issue with my father. And then along with him I went to the newspaper, the publishers. And I discussed with them that why don't your newspaper is reached to our locality. Then they said that there is very less number of people and it's very remote. So we are not providing the newspaper. Then I said that why can we take that initiative by ourselves? And then the answer was that you are too young. And I said that can I have it in my mother's name? And then immediately they agreed. And on the same day, I have taken that agency at the age of my class 6 in my mother's name and started distributing the newspaper, that is the Assam Tribune. And still I remember that news agency is still continuing in Assam, although I have handed over to some other people. And that really makes a very good opportunity, giving me not the newspaper available to the locality, even it gives me a regular income source on that time. Anyway, this is one of these things, but I will start mostly concentrating my rickshaw journey. I'm also studying in Assam